$0.87, and the next day would be Christmas. She had been saving every penny she could for months with this result.
Is it okay, the story?
Yeah,
the first one.
Can you?
Oh, please.
Sorry.
Okay, can you please? Just essentially wait to do it.
Continue, sorry.
It's respect to Japanese.
$1.87. That was all. Three times Della counted it. $1.87. And the next day would be Christmas. She had been saving every penny she could for months with this result. $20 a week doesn't go far. Expenses had been greater than she had expected. They always are. Only $1.87 to buy a present for Jim, her Jim. Many a happy hour she had spent planning for something nice for Jim. She wanted something rare and sterling, something that would be worthy of being owned by Jim. She was standing before the mirror, looking at herself. And then her eyes sparkled. She pulled down her hair and let it fall down to its full length. Now, there were two possessions of which this young couple was very proud of. One was Jim's gold watch. That was his father's and his grandfather's. Another was Della's hair. So now Della's beautiful hair was shining like a cascade of brown waters. She looked at herself, and then she wore her coat and went out. Where she stopped, the sign read, Madame Sofronie, hair goods of all styles. Up one floor, she ran and collected herself, panting. Will you buy my hair? She asked. I buy hair, said Madame Sofronie. Take your head off and let's see what you have. So down rippled the brown cascade. $20, said Madame Sofronie. Give it to me, quickly, said Della. And the next 2 hours she spent looking all over the stores to find a present for Jim. She found it, finally. It was meant for Jim and no one else. It was a platinum chain, simple in design, properly proclaiming its value by substance alone. So she knew, as soon as she saw it, she knew it must be Jim's. It was like him. Quietness and value, the description that could be applied to both. $21 they took from her, and she ran home with 87 cents. Jim was never late, so she held her beautiful present in her hands and sat next to the corner of the table, next to the door that he always entered. She had a habit of saying little silent prayers about simplest everyday things, so she whispered, please God, make him think I'm still pretty. So the door opened and Jim stepped in. He looked thin and very serious. He stopped inside the door. His eyes were fixed upon Della. And there was an expression in his face that she could not read and terrified her. It was not horror, no anger, no anything that she had prepared herself for. That's why she cried. Jim, darling, don't look at me that way. This is still me, Della. My hair grows so fast. I had to cut my hair and sold it because I couldn't live through Christmas without giving you a present. So, you sold your hair? Said he. Then he drew a package and threw it upon the table. Della unwrapped the package, and then a sudden cry of joy, and then a feminine change to hysterical tears and wails, for there lay the combs, the set of combs that she had worshipped for a long time. They were beautiful combs, the tortoise shell with pure tortoise shell with jewel rings. They were expensive, she knew. But now they were hers. But her hair was gone. She said, Jim, darling, thank you so much. And my hair grows so fast. Thank you. And then she remembered about her own gift. So she said, oh, darling. And she held out her present to him. Isn't it a dandy? She said. Let's try on your watch. Give it to me, please, quickly. But instead of obeying Jim, he tumbled down on the couch, put his hands under his head, and smiled. Della, he said, let's put our presents away because they are too good to use at present. I had to sell my watch to buy you this present. So maybe are the wise men, wonderfully wise men, who brought the gifts to the baby Christ in the crib. This Maggie, they invented the art of giving Christmas gifts. This story is a story of this young couple, these two people, who foolishly and unwisely sacrificed their greatest treasures in their life for each other. But of all the people in the world who give presents, these two people are the wisest. These two people are the mightiest.